Let's take a look at what's new in C# 11. On the left, we have Visual Studio 2022 with C# 10 and .NET 6. And on the right, we have 2022 Preview with C# 11 and .NET 7. We can run these two apps and see that they work fine. The first feature we'll look at are new lines within interpolated strings. Imagine we have a class like this, channel, list of subscribers, and so on. So the first thing we do is have a variable for our channel, new channel. Very good. And then we want to do console.WriteLine with a dollar for the interpolated string. The first subscriber was channel.subscribers.first. And we can see that that is pretty long. That is a pretty long string and it's going off the screen, which isn't great. We can also do WriteLine, this channel has sub count subscribers, like so. Now that's cool, but if we wanted to do new lines in here, C# 10 is going to complain. We are not allowed to do this. However, if we take all this magic over into C# 11, let's get that class in, copy and paste all this stuff in, we will see that C# 11 allows you to do new lines within the holes of interpolated strings. Let's take a look at list patterns. Imagine we wanted to get a variable saying Gary, the first subscriber. We could use link to do this by doing channel.subscribers first Gary. And we do console.WriteLine. Gary was the first subscriber. Very good. Run the app. And it says true. So far, so good. If we wanted to do this in C# 11, this obviously still works. So we can copy this code over and it works a treat. But there is a smarter way of doing it. We can use list patterns. If we do channel.subscribers is Gary dot and run the app, we can see that it's true. So what if we wanted to have a Boolean variable that said Gary was first and Steve was last? We could do this with link, obviously, like this, channel.subscribers.last, Steve, run the app, and it says true. Very good. But with list patterns, we can be cleverer and go channel.subscribers is Gary dot dot Steve. Run the app, and this also says true. Very cool. Now imagine we want to get a list of the subscribers between Gary and Steve. We could do this with link. We could do this with get range. Kind of looks a little bit like this, not very nice. And if we wanted to write this list out to the console, we would do something like this. Let's add another subscriber, let's call them Dino. Run the app, bang, we get Nigel and Dino. They subscribed between Barry and Steve. Now, if we wanted to do the same thing over here, we'll add Dino to our list, and we can do something a little bit special. If you change your list to an array, despite the name list patterns, this particular trick doesn't work on lists. There you go. Very good. So we can do something like the following. If channel.subscribers, and using our list patterns, we can do this. Barry dot dot var subscribers between Barry and Steve. We'll use that as the variable name. Steve at the end. Very good. We can see here that we've captured this pattern here. So there is now an enumerable to loop through. And if we run the app, we can see that Nigel and Dino have been captured from the list pattern. Very nice. Next, let's take a look at parameter null checking. So imagine we have this, and we wanted to add this to the list, add name, very good. And up in our program, we can do channel.subscribe Ted, like so. Run the app, we see that Ted has been added to the list. Now, if we wanted to prevent null being added, in C# 10, we would do something like, if name is null, throw new null argument exception, name of name, very good. And if we run the app, we get a crash. Doesn't like that very much. Now let's go and do the same thing over in C# 11. We'll take our method here, update the subscribe method, and we'll do this. We will subscribe with Ted to test it. And we can see that everybody is in the list. Very good. And if we swap this for null, we get a crash. Very good. However, there is a shortcut to this in C# 11. We can literally delete all this and do bang, bang, like so. And if we run the app again, we still get a crash. So this is a shortcut to writing this. Very useful. If you found that useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Cheers.